Good morning and welcome to WFMS, where we're getting the news out to you. Hey, Franklin Middle School staff and students, who has it better than us? Nobody. That's right. Good morning, everyone. Today is Thursday. It is December 10th, and we're counting down here. We've got a little bit of time. I've been getting emails from students. Students, the time is now. You've got to get this thing going. You got to get the train on the track. You got to get the car out of the garage. We've got a little bit of time to get these assignments done. Don't wait. Communicate. Keep it going if you've been going well. But we've got just a little bit of time for the end of this quarter. All right. A-Day students, you're going to be Zooming with your teachers. B-Day students, you'll be going to your teacher's Canvas pages asynchronously. Whether it's an A-Day or B-Day for you, you're making sure you're going to your teacher's Canvas pages at those prescribed times. Take a look here. Oh, let's go back. We want to say Happy Hanukkah. Today is the beginning of Hanukkah, and we've got a slide coming up on that. Stay tuned on that. All right, today's welcoming ritual. Got a little bucket list. What is one thing on your bucket list you want to do before you finish school? What is one thing you'd like to do, one thing you'd like to accomplish before you finish school? Think about that one. Think about that. What would you like to get accomplished? All right, I like that one. Very broad question. Lots of different directions you can go on that one. All right, some important dates for students. Now through the December 21st, we've got our FMS food drive going. It's going really well. Now, take a look. End of second quarter is going to be on the 21st. That's in bright yellow and bold. And of course, we don't have school on December 22nd through January 4th. That is going to be our winter break. So the countdown is on. Take a look. We've got tutoring going on. Tutoring tonight. We had our first set of tutoring on Tuesday. Went really well. We had some students sign up. So on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 3 to 5, that's tonight, you can Zoom. You sign up for a tutoring time slot on the form on the FMS webpage, and then a Zoom link will be sent out to you to the students that sign up. You do not have to stay from 3 to 5. You can go from 3 to 3:30. You can get a little bit of help. And then move on with your day, with your life, if you will. Okay? Want to also remind students, and many of you are taking advantage of those teachers' office hours. Those take place between 1:30 and 2:50. So no excuses. We got to get the help when we need it. And we can go to those teachers' office hours, and we can go to tutoring Tuesdays and Thursdays, 3 to 5. All right. All right. Today is the first day of Hanukkah. We want to talk a little bit about this. Hanukkah is the Jewish Festival of Lights, and it remembers the rededication of the second Jewish temple in Jerusalem in Israel. This happened in the 160s BC, before Jesus was born. And during Hanukkah, on each of the eight nights, a candle is lit in a special menorah, also known as a candelabra, called the Hanukkah. So today is the first day of Hanukkah, and it kind of leads into our next slide. Do you celebrate something at this time of year? Any type of traditions that go on in December? And if you do, take a picture of that. Or if you've got a picture, send that in to us. You can send that in to Mariotti at sps186.org or Argino at sps186.org. And please do so by December 16th. We'd love to see those photos. Canned food drives in full swing. We partner with Grace Lutheran Food Pantry. We'll take checks. We'll take cash. We'll take cans, we'll take boxes of non-perishables. So do you need an example of what to bring in? Take a look at the slide below. We've talked quite a bit about this. We can also do a pickup. You can drop it off. If you need a pickup, you call 217-787-3006. We can make that happen. We have been charging ahead. We're gonna get some results out to you soon to see where we're at, but the early returns are things are going really, really well. So. Teachers, students, consider contributing to the 2020 virtual Beta Club canned food drive. It's going really well. And just maybe, you can win a chance to win a $5 Baskin-Robbins gift card. Any student who donates will be entered for a chance to win, and donations can be any non-perishable food item or a cash donation. So please, don't do it for the ice cream. Do it because it's the right thing to do. It helps our local community. And keeps the tradition alive. Franklin Middle School, we are the champions of charities. We are also the champions of having some slides that we've talked about since day one, minute one, second one of this school year. And here, sixth graders, is your sixth grade daily schedule. You have seen this. Today, yes, it's Thursday. Yes, you're going to go to your teacher's Canvas pages at these prescribed times. Seventh grade, yep, it is still Thursday. We want you to go to your teacher's Canvas pages at these prescribed times. And finally, yep, eighth grade, it's Thursday. You had a small little adjustment. We have, you know, seamlessly transitioned into this new schedule. You're going to your teacher's Canvas pages and you're Zooming Tuesday through Friday in AP, Math, Lit, Writing, History, Science, Departmentalized Resource, and Guided Tutorial. And you're going to your teacher's Canvas pages at these prescribed times. Let me just give you a little bit of a hint here. Go to your classes at the prescribed times. That's what the Falcon says. That's what Principal Davis says. That's me. And we want you to do so. We're getting into those good habits. And those good habits mean knowing where to go and at what time. All right. Falcon blog in full effect. Each day, we'd like students to check out the daily blog on the right-hand side of the FMS webpage. We'd like you to share your opinions and your feelings and advice on the daily question. We want you to engage. We want you to take a look at that question, and then you can check back and see if anybody's put anything on your comments. We want you to take a look at what others think and feel. And we're doing some drawings around that. So we're seeing those teachers contribute to that, students contribute to that, administrators, secretaries. It's a nice thing to see. A good way to start your day, easy question to engage with. And these have been very nice. These are shortcuts, or cheats, if you will, some Chromebook keyboard shortcuts. And we went over these the other day. I'm not going to go over them again, but just remember that you can find this resource on the morning announcements. All right, love seeing those. Looks like we've talked about this one just a bit. There's going to be a holiday giveaway. They're going to do coats, hats, scarves, blankets, gloves, masks, hand sanitizer. And it's going to happen on December 19th. There's some community partners that are helping make this happen. Hy-Vee, E.L. Pruitt, Local 137 Steam Fitters, Capital Cruisers, Molina Healthcare, and Lakeisha Purchase, Capital Township Trustee, and they are making this all happen on December 19th. If you're in need of a coat, you'll need to be there. The student will need to be there. And that is going to be distributed on December 19th at 2800 East Cook, here in Springfield from 12 to 2:30. So consider that, especially if you're in need. All right, take a look here. We've got our November Students of the Month. We've got Mr. Helton and Isaiah. Love the thumbs up. We've got Mrs. Herbst and Shima. Love the thumbs up. And I think those are some peace signs. Chucking the deuces. Love seeing that. All right, we've got Mrs. Huffman and Sawyer. Great photo of both of them. All right, take a look. We've got the thumbs up from Mrs. Empson and Donald. Looks like Donald's got two thumbs up. Mrs. Empson's got one thumbs up. All right, excellent. And last but not least, we've got Mrs. Giacchino and Eden, both with thumbs up. I love it. I love seeing the photos. I love seeing the thumbs up. I love these students of the month taking care of business. Teachers, great job recommending those classroom superstars. And let's return the favor, students. Let's give some shout outs. All right, here's a shout out to Mrs. Jones. This one's coming from John B. Mrs. Jones is a person that makes science more interesting and has given a smile to her students every day. Thank you for all you do. You are the best. Mrs. Jones, that's coming from John B. Very nice, John B. All right, what do we have next? Hey, this one's to Mrs. Weekly. This one's coming from Rain. When I'm in math, you will wait until someone gets the math. Thank you for being my math teacher. That's a great, great compliment. Yeah, we want to wait until they get it. We want just to forge ahead. All right, great job, Mrs. Weekly. All right, we've got Mrs. West next. This one's coming from Wayne. Mrs. West is always smiling when I join Zoom. Yeah, I think that's a good, promising practice. If I were to go into a Zoom and the person was like this, grumpy, I don't know if I'd want to go to that Zoom. Moving on. All right, and this one's from Shima. This is a shout out to Mrs. Womble. Miss Womble is my favorite teacher because she's so nice and funny. When I need help, she helps me and reminds me when I have missed work. She is so nice. Hey, very nice. Nice words there. And last but not least, another one from for Mrs. Jones. This is an anonymous AP student. Mystery, intrigue. She learned about Among Us for us. What more is there to say? You know what? Mrs. Jones is very hip. She's got her ear to the ground. It does not surprise me that she learned about Among Us so she could be among her students. All right, moving on. Hey, if you're looking for that shout out, want to give your teachers a shout out, you can find that button on the FMS webpage. It's on the left-hand side. It's very colorful, and it is almost impossible to miss. All right, math counts news. This is great. Do you like to solve challenging math problems? If so, we have a math counts team. Now, you might want to know what it is. All right. Math counts. We're doing math problems, challenging ones, collaboratively, sometimes independently, sometimes working and chewing on the problems. It's a lot of fun. So Mr. Nofel will be having a math counts practice starting at 1 o'clock on Monday, December 14th. Students interested can contact Mr. Nofel at nofel@sps186, and he will send you a Zoom link. Please make sure you have a calculator for practice. Love seeing our math counts kick up. All right, the Scholastic Bowl question of the day. This one is in music, fine arts. As a young man, he spent 3 years studying with French music teacher Nadia Boulanger. After he returned to America, he wrote the scores for the 1930s films The Grapes of Wrath and Our Town. Name this composer of a Lincoln portrait, Fanfare for the Common Man, and music for the ballets Rodeo, Billy the Kid, and Appalachian Spring. Okay, this is an old one. This is a throwback. This is one you might have to Google. It's a throwback, but it's trivia. It's a Scholastic Bowl question, and that's what it's about. Think you know the answer? It's coming up soon. All right, take a look at the Bahrain teaser of the day. Okay. What is the sum of all positive integers from 1 to 30, inclusive, that are neither multiples of 2 nor perfect squares? What is the sum of all positive integers from 1 to 30, inclusive, that are neither multiples of 2 nor perfect squares? Okay, we've got some hints, we've got some tips, we've got some suggestions in there. We've got to take a look at that box with the numbers in it. I think you know the answer. That one will come up. That might be one you got to come back and take a look and see if you've solved it. All right, word of the day. Students, I can't share with you how much I enjoy the word of the day. I like to enunciate the word of the day. I like to talk about the word of the day and see how I can use the word of the day. And today's word of the day is Kindle. No, we're not talking about an ebook. We're talking about Kindle. To call forth as an emotion, feeling, or response. Here's the example they give. Now, some of these are a little bit, not the best, but here we go. Recently in class, I saw the fire of an idea flicker in a first-year student's eyes. And so to kindle it, I cold called him. Okay, kindle, to call forth, to get something going, emotion, feeling, or response. All right, see how you could use that one today. Kindle. All right, and on this day in history, December 10th, 1901, I didn't know this one, I like it. The first Nobel Prize was awarded, 1901. So that's going on over 100, going on close to 120 years. Wow, pretty cool. On to our bad pun and joke. Deep breath, yep. Shout out to whoever created the word plethora. It means a lot. Yeah, let's move on. And let me give a little explanation. The word plethora means a lot. We have not had a plethora of good jokes lately. Just bad ones. All right, moving on. Happy birthday to Justin Witherspoon. Happy birthday from us to you, Justin. Take a look at the weather. Gotta love it. We've got 50s in December. 56 is the high today. Friday, 50s, a little rainy. Saturday, 42, a little rainy. You know what? We'll take it. Nothing we can do about it. You just have to accept it and deal with it. Take a look here. We've got our Scholastic Bowl answer. Grapes of Wrath, amongst others. was Aaron Copeland. And the math brain teaser, which you'll probably have to go back to make the connection with, math brain teaser answer was 190. Give yourself a pat on the back if you had 190 in Aaron Copeland. And now, as we prepare for a productive day, let us observe a moment of silence. Now let us rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right, take a look here. We've got a great kudos, another congratulations to another student. We've got a classroom finalist for the MLK, Martin Luther King essay. And we want to give a kudos and congratulations to Maria. She's a sixth grade student at FMS and is a finalist in Miss Becker's class for the MLK, Martin Luther King essay contest. Her video will play at the end of the announcements today. Great job, Maria. Really proud of that. And you know what, Natalie? I love this piece of digital artwork. This was submitted by Natalie W. Students, you've been submitting pieces of art, masterpieces, etc. And rest assured, we'll get them on there. We love seeing them. We love seeing that creative vibe. And we think it's really cool that you submit those. So thank you for doing so. All right, Franklin Middle School staff and students, we need to have a great day. And remember, it's all about choices. Read, write, and respond at Franklin Middle School. It's our focus.
Hi, I'm Maria, and this is my Martin Luther King essay. Martin Luther King's famous speech, "I've been to the mountaintop," inspired many people back then when he first spoke it, and it still does. Martin Luther King Jr. was a social activist and Baptist minister who took a large role in the American Civil Rights Movement until he was assassinated in 1968. He was also a father, married to Coretta Scott King. They had four children, two daughters and two sons. His daughters are Yolanda and Bernice King, and his sons are Dexter King and Martin Luther King III. He was born on January 15th of 1929 in his maternal grandparents' large Victorian house. In Atlanta, he worked odd jobs and studied, slowly developing a reputation as a preacher. In the sermon, Dr. King declares, "I might not get there with you." I think he made this statement to tell others that even if they make it to wherever they are trying to get to, not everyone will be there for you or make it with you. Sometimes you have to do things by yourself. For me, this makes me feel weighed and responsible, frightened and challenged. It makes me feel weighed and responsible because in some situations, all the pressure will be put on your shoulders, like a heavy bag of sand that only you can carry. And if you mess up one thing, everything could go wrong. In addition, everyone is counting on you. It makes me feel frightened because in a lot of situations, I like to have friends and family with me to help on whatever I need help with. Finally, it makes me feel challenged because it feels like it's hard to do or get done when no one is there to help you. You're on your own. More deeply, if I know those who are following me would get there but I wouldn't, I would do everything in my power to help them. Supply them with everything they need, encourage them to keep going, and if I had to, tell them they needed to make it no matter what. In this speech, Dr. King talks a lot about God and refers to him as Almighty, Lord, and also mentions Jesus too. I can infer that he was Christian, and he looked to God for help whenever he was struggling. Dr. King put God in the center of his life. He speaks, "Strangely enough, I would turn to the Almighty and say, if you allow me to live just a few years in the second half of the 20th century, I will be happy." Somehow, I can tell that he is not demanding anything from God and not even asking. He is simply telling him how he feels and what he would like to do. Dr. King also speaks, "Now that's a strange statement to make because the world is all messed up. The nation is sick, trouble is in the land, confusion is all around. That's a strange statement. But I know, somehow, that only when it is dark can you see the stars." And right away it hits you. Something just snaps inside your head. You can tell that he wished to do this so that he can help other people, so we can help them to see the light and look to God for guidance.
Good morning, Falcons. As you know, the Falcon blog has been back up and running, and I promised some random drawings for students and staff members that have been participating. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to draw two student names and one staff name in just a second. But before we do the drawing, I want to refresh your memory on how to get to the Falcon blog, and that is on the Franklin Middle School webpage. You scroll down here and it's on the right and it just says the Falcon blog. You're going to click there, but then you're going to make sure you're logged in using your district username and password. And once you click on that, then you can submit your responses to the daily question. Some of you can even go back to previous ones if you would like. The Falcon blog is a great way to share your thoughts and opinions on the daily question. And just as important, it's a great way for you to read others' perspectives on the question. So I do want to share an example of how you can learn from others using December 9th's question. And that was, with only 2 weeks left into the semester, what do you need to do between now and then to earn your best grades? And this here is just an example of the many ways and ideas that you can make sure your grades are where they need to be. So Matthew, for example, says, I need to do good on my upcoming test. I need to keep on doing my assignments and my homework best as possible so I can keep the good grades that I have. Caillou says, focus on work. Ray says, do all my assignments, study for tests and ask questions if I need help. So far we have such great thoughts here. Emily says, if I don't have the best of grades, I would need to either go to tutoring or ask a teacher after school what I can do. Continue doing all my work and turning it in on time, going to all my classes and working as hard as I can to get grades up is Letitiana's idea. Rain says, if I don't have the best of grades, I would either go to tutoring. Mr. Davis says that he thinks prioritizing and figuring out what you can and can't do to help your grade is an important first step. For example, I would suggest talking to each of your teachers, emailing each of your teachers to see what you can do and what you can make up. Another great idea is from Sabrina. Just keep up on your work and keep, she wants to keep her grades where they're at. Gloria says, I would need to turn in any missing assignments, go to class on time, and get above 70% on her grade for an assignment. And lastly, Danasia's idea is, I would need to keep doing what I am and stay on track with upcoming assignments. So I wanted to share these because this is, first of all, thank you all for sharing your thoughts and opinions on this prompt, but we can also get ideas from others just by going and reading the blog. And in summary, I think there's a common theme here, and it is to prioritize, ask for help, email your teachers, take advantage of tutoring on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and you can sign up for that on the Franklin Middle School webpage. So thank you all for submitting your names, and now we're going to move on to our drawing. So I have entered all of the names of students that have commented on the blog since we started it back up, and it is time to spin.
Grandma got run over by a reindeer, walking home from our house Christmas Eve.
It is so awesome to see how many names we have. Look at all those students that took time to participate. And it's not too late, guys. Starting today, go check out that Falcon blog. Our first student winner is Brian D. Way to go. And our next student winner. Way to go, guys. Simon and Brian, you will be getting a special surprise delivered to your house. And now it's time for the staff. The staff drawing. You are going to receive a surprise off of your favorites list, which is a reminder, staff, don't forget to go fill out your favorites list.
Italian Christmas donkey. La, la, la.
Lucky staff member. Mr. Helton, congratulations. Okay, guys. Don't forget, go check out that Falcon blog. And also, while I'm here, keep up on those staff shout outs. Those have been adding smiles to staff members' faces. And I love it that it's not just students, parents can submit it. Staff members can share shout outs for other staff members. So keep sharing that kindness. Have a great day.